In your book, you cite the story of Dr. Ruit as someone who takes the road less traveled and blazes a trail. Talk about him.
Well, Sanduk, what an amazing guy. He was born into poverty, you know, and becomes an eye doctor and gets offers to work in Australia, gets offers to work in the U.S. He's from a little village in Nepal. And somebody like that, getting an offer to work at Johns Hopkins or getting an offer to work in Australia, would jump at it. And he says, no, I got to make sure that my people who cannot afford cataract operation because it's so expensive, they have a second chance at life. And he creates lenses which cost $2. And he creates a surgical procedure that costs under $25. The entire machinery, the medical machinery of the world says this is wrong, this is dangerous, and you're doing the wrong thing. And he sticks to his guns. He says, no, I will do it. Can you imagine the unpopularity? Can you imagine the loneliness this man must have faced? And his own family probably said, why don't you take a job at Johns Hopkins? But he sticks by it. He had amazing opportunity to make tremendous amounts of money. But eventually, he gives the world something that was needed. And now amongst his patrons is the U.S. Army and many, many other organizations around the world. Now, that's what I call strong leadership energy. Never give up. Because the difference between a leader and a non-leader is non-leaders give up. He had the right values. He had a values-based purpose. So that equipped him to face all kinds of resistance and still remain strong.